Christopher going, coming to the rescue of Brian Christopher just when it looked like, oh! Brian Christopher just nailed Doug Gilbert. Brian is blinded by the powder that was thrown in his eyes. PG-187 is out.
Hey, let me tell you something. If you don't understand what you did to me, pal, then maybe you'll understand this.
Razor Ramon is dead.
Russell, Michael, St. John, all ready to go with another big day of USWA Championship Wrestling. And Michael, it is very, very unusual when we have a major title change, but when you have two of them, boy, we've got something.
I tell you, every week, this week is upset week in the USWA. I don't think there's any other way you can say it, but we have an upset champion, to be honest with you, and an upset ex-champion also, the new unified heavyweight champion. Is the icon Dutch Mantell with an upset victory over Jerry the King Lawler?
Better you saying it. I couldn't bring myself to say that. That just stops me cold. That's right. We have a new unified heavyweight champion.
We also have new tag team champions.
That's right.
And I'm happy to announce the new tag team champions are Steve Dunn and Flash Flanagan.
Yes, sir.
But that, too, was somewhat of an upset victory over PG-13.
That's right. As a matter of fact, because Dunn and Flanagan had not been together really normally long enough in what you would think to develop a championship team. They did come through and they beat a very experienced team in PG-13. So that's the action that's coming down for two championships, and I mean, we've got a lot of other things. Madman Rex Rod Price is
yes.
going to be in here.
I got you.
I'm thinking about Rex King.
I know. There's another madman.
Yeah, right.
Well, first of all, the USWA office has demanded today on television and signed a return tag team championship match. That will be coming up later on the program today. Plus, Lance, when I was coming in today, and I don't know if you noticed it, but there was a lot of commotion outside the studio. And did you come to the studio in a limo today? Is this Lance Russell coming in?
What is this? No, what me? What?
This is what I saw earlier today.
Yeah.
There's a limo coming into the studio here, and I have no idea who it is. But with the escort.
Well, I'm going to tell you the way it's been going in the USWA, and every week a brand new face coming rolling in here. I don't know, and maybe we'll get an opportunity to find out who is in that limo. Now, that's what I would expect would be befitting Michael St. John to come to work in, but we'll see. And, well, no, I don't know. Who is in the limo?
Good question. Well,
we'll find out. I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll try to find out, but we've got today one of the big announcements that Michael has already made, and we're really looking forward to it. We appreciate matchmaker James Beard being sure that we get a return tag team title match. It'll be here right today, TV time situation. You'll have a chance to see that match coming up a little later on. Michael, let's get on. We've got
a lot of stuff
to do, and we'll be back in just one moment.
Don't go away, fans. Coming up next, Too Sexy Brian Christopher. Stay with us.
Are you ready for some football?
The wait is finally over. Season tickets are now on sale for the Oilers games at the Liberty Bowl here in Memphis. Be a part of history by cheering on Tennessee's first NFL professional football team.
I've won the Heisman. I won Rookie of the Year. Come see what I do next.
See your Tennessee Oilers in their debut season. Get your season tickets now.
Let's say you have $200 and you're out to buy a new suit. You could go to a department store and buy this suit for around $200, if you're lucky. Or you could go to S&K Menswear and get two handsome wool blend suits for less than you might pay for one. This suit and this suit for less than $200. That's about half what you'd expect to pay, right? Now, where are you going to buy your next suit?
Shop the grand opening of our new superstore at the Commons, across from Wolf Chase Galleria.
Liberty Land, twist and shout on the new wipeout. Kids are getting
It's like spinning in space. Liberty Land, Liberty Land, a happy face place. Liberty Land, Liberty Land, putting a smile on your face.
Open Wednesday through Sunday.
Are we having fun yet? Well, at Sonic we are. It's summer. And at Sonic, that means fun food and fun drinks in a ton of flavors, like our shakes and malts. We still make them by hand. We even have a new peanut butter fudge shake.
Right now at Sonic, any of our handmade shakes, along with a famous Sonic burger, is just $1.99.
Sound like fun?
We've been having fun all summer long.
What are you waiting for?
Exciting times in the USWA. We've got in the heavyweight division, we've got three guys that are after each other's throat. The champion, of course, is Doomsday, and then you've got Spellbinder and Brian Christopher.
And then you got Doug Gilbert coming into the picture.
Yeah, and we'll talk about him in just a moment. And then in the tag situation, you've got PG-13, former champion,
right,
current champion Stephen Dunn and Flash Flanagan, and then the newest team to be created, Paul Diamond and Rex King. And these three guys, those three teams are after each other. One of the incidents that took place last week that was kind of unfortunate, but in the heat of the battle, things like this happened, Michael, and I'm talking about the deal when Brian Christopher ended up DDTing Doug Gilbert, who was in there to help him out.
And Brian couldn't see, and that's...
Got powder right in his eye. Let's take a look and see what happened on that. Gonna cross body him, and
now,
he got the
now
referee.
Look
powder.
Right there. It's powder right in his eyes. Look
right
at that.
Right in his eyes, and here comes PG-187.
I can't watch this anymore.
And
I
look,
cannot watch
he's got
it.
That metal chair. Doug Gilbert goes up into the ring. The chair rips him with a fist.
Holy cow. Doug Gilbert coming to the rescue of Brian Christopher just when it looked like... Oh! Brian Christopher just nailed Doug Gilbert. Brian is blinded by the powder that was thrown in his eyes. PG-187 is out of there. Here comes Spellbinder. He's going to wail on him with that chair. And Spellbinder took the chair away from Brian Christopher, and hopefully cooler heads will prevail. Brian Christopher, I don't think, realized that Doug Gilbert was in the ring.
No, he didn't know. And now Gilbert, who has a short fuse himself, both of those guys, and that's one of the reasons they used to have such great matches. They started from dead still into raging mad with inside of 30 seconds. Spellbinder is trying to be the peacemaker up there as he saw what happened. Yeah, that was an interesting situation that developed like that. You know the past between Gilbert and Brian Christopher, so it's not totally surprising. Well, let's go to the ring now. We're ready. We'll talk more about it. We tried to get a hold of Doug, but the voice messages that we left for him were not returned, and so far he has not shown up today. Let's go up to Tony Friedman right now with this next
Thank you very much, Lance Russell. We are ready to go with a super day of action. Our opening contest scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, wrestling out of Nutbush in Memphis, Tennessee, weighing 281 pounds, here is Big McNasty. His opponent, also wrestling out of Memphis, Tennessee, weighing 225 pounds, too sexy, Brian Christopher. One fall, 10-minute time limit.
Okay, Michael. Referee Bill Rush, set and ready to go, and we're ready to ring the bell.
Lance,
I
think it's real interesting that things in the USWA are all coming down in threes. You were mentioning earlier we have a champion in Doomsday. He is the heavyweight champion in the USWA. And you have prime contenders in Brian Christopher and Spellbinder. And obviously, you've got to include Doug Gilbert in that picture because he's in the USWA for one thing, and that's to be on top and be the champion. Also, in the tag team title situation, you had PG-13 as the champions. They get beat in somewhat of an upset victory by Steve Dunn and his new partner, Flash Flanagan. Now on the scene, Paul Diamond, and his partner is the former partner, if you would, of Steve Dunn, Rex King. So you got Diamond and King, you got Dunn and Flanagan, and you got PG-13. And goodness knows where those belts are going to end up.
Yeah, and PG-13, they figure that those belts are theirs. And Brian Christopher is the guy who figures that heavyweight title belt is his. Speaking of Brian, he had some comments that while this match is going on against Big McNasty, we'll take a listen to Brian.
I want to get some things straight with a few people. First of all, Doug Gilbert. Now, Doug, last week when you rolled in the ring and I DDT'd you, that was simply a mistake. I made a mistake. Have you never made a mistake in your life? I apologize time and time again for it, and it's getting to the point to where if you accept my apology, that's fine. But if you don't accept it, that's fine also, because I'm looking for one thing, and I can't be worried about who's my friend and who's not my friend, because I'm out for that USWA heavyweight title. The Spellbinder, Doomsday, and you also, Doug Gilbert, if this is a race, you're looking at the one that's going to finish that line first, because I want that belt, and you know I always get what I want.
Back again and pops him over the hip, arm drags him down onto the mat, and Big McNasty, who is just flat, he's better than 280, hefty son of a gun. He saw the athletic moves and the physical strength of Brian Christopher. There's a guy who is to say he's intense is putting it mildly. I'm talking about Brian.
Absolutely, and it may be even underscored in the fact that he had a chance recently to get back that unified title in a triangular match, which is certainly a unique match and the first time ever in the USWA, and through some circumstances that may or may not have been brought on by Brian Christopher, he did not get that belt back. So I know right now that Brian has one thing in mind, and he's showing the intensity in the ring right now. He wants that belt around his waist.
He grabbed those ropes and got Big McNasty off of him as he was getting ready to spring down on him. And now he comes up top and kicks him down to the mat. Referee Bill Rutt checks the super kick. One, two, three.
He got it. Impressive victory for Brian Christopher. And again, showing the intensity that we all know that Brian has, but maybe even turning it up a notch as he takes the victory here over Big McNasty.
Watch Brian over there, Michael. And when people go over there and put their hands up to high-five him, you better know what you're doing, because he'll knock you right out of your shoes when he high-fives you. We got more great action. We have a tag team championship match coming up later in today's program, and we'll be back in just a moment.
It's color the weather time.
This is my house in a rainbow.
It's easy. Just pick up a form at any participating McDonald's. Draw or paint your favorite kind of weather. And drop off your finished form at McDonald's. Daily winners drawn at random will see their art live on WMC Action News AM.
This is a tornado.
You could win some cool prizes, too.
This is my dad.
I'm Jim, and this is my McDonald's.
Color the weather with McDonald's and TV5 today.
Take on TV's best entertainment network, HBO, and TV's best movie network, Cinemax. Take two, HBO and Cinemax, and get six channels for the price of two with multi-channel HBO and Cinemax. That's right. When you order HBO and Cinemax, you'll get six different programs to choose from whenever you want to watch. Take two and get six. Multi-channel HBO and Cinemax. Call now.
Get 50% off installation when you buy the Smart Choice package. Call 365-6004.
Discount Sammy's continues the original $2 for $100 suit sale of the century with unbelievable back-to-school prices on shorts, $2 for $20, tops, $10, back-to-school jeans, $2 for $35, feeler shoes at unheard-of discount prices. Come to Discount Sammy's for the blowout back-to-school sale and get suits, $2 for $100, shorts, $2 for $20, jeans, $2 for $35. Discount Sammy's downtown on Main.
Looking to save some cash on a new Ford car or truck?
For me!
During Ford's factory-authorized clearance, get low 2.9% financing on Escort or Ford Ranger. That could save you over $1,900 on Escort and $1,600 on Ranger.
Wow, that's huge!
2.9% financing could save you as much as $30 a month on Ranger, enough for a movie and dinner for two, and as much as $40 a month on Escort, enough for three CDs of your favorite music. Don't miss your Ford dealer's factory-authorized clearance!
This is hard. I mean it. I'm telling you the truth. It's not easy to get up here, but son of a gun, and when you're going to do an interview with the new unified heavyweight title holder, I normally would look forward to that. I can't hardly say it, the fact that Dutch Mantell is the new unified heavyweight title holder, and he is. Oh, come on, what is this? Oh, the girls with the beautiful pretzels. Are you kidding me? That's too much. Michael, would you please? I can't do it. I can't do it. I'm sorry. I'm not going to get up here with Mantell.
Hold on a second here, Dutch. I wasn't ready for this, but the new unified heavyweight champion.
Do I look good today or what? Girls, do I look good?
Don't you?
I look great.
Don't you think this is a little carrying it a bit too far?
Brother, now everybody knows who was in the limo this morning. It was me. I was in the limo because the unified world's heavyweight champion gets preferential treatment. I didn't know that, but I know it now. And you see, I got all my hair. I got my trademark mustache. I ain't lost nothing because I got this. And I am so happy. I am so happy. And Lance, you should come over here and join me in my moment of joy because I worked long and hard and they said it couldn't be done. Yeah, I did it. I did it because I sacrificed everything. I poured it back down and I reached up and I got it and I took it and you're standing here right now.
I think you got it right. You took it, and it was an upset victory. I will definitely say that.
But right now, what I want to say, since I am the leader of the USWA, and I am the unified heavyweight champion, I am putting together right now an organization. I'm going to call this organization Team Icon. And I got some members in this. And right now, I would like to introduce my first inductee and the Team Icon, a close personal friend of mine. Ladies and gentlemen, let's all stand as one and give a big hand to the madman. Rod Price is going to draw me out here right now. My team, first inductee.
Team Icon.
Team Icon, Rod.
It's a pleasure to be with you.
You're on the ground floor of a great happening. I'm going to lead, and this man is going to lead the USWA into the new millennium. Now, I have another inductee, a real good friend of mine, and he touches my heart, a man who was left abandoned and orphaned. Ladies and gentlemen, another hand for the USWA heavyweight champion, the massive Doomsday, if Doomsday would join me out here. Another member of Team Icon.
So this team, so you're putting together a collection of wrestlers, is that it? Team Icon.
Like? Well, I'm not through. And my final member right now, another close personal friend of mine, my World Wrestling Federation champion and a man I've known for years, another big hand for Justin Hope Bradshaw.
Blackjack Bradshaw.
There he comes out here. And Blackjack, tell these people exactly what we're going to do if people get in our way.
Get in our way. Let me tell you something. I was sitting starving in Europe in a small trailer when Dutch Mantell found me, brought me the World Wrestling Federation fame. So let me tell you this. You think you ought to kiss Dutch Mantell feet? Lawler, Brian, Christopher, every one of you, I'll make you kiss his hairy butt. There ain't nothing anybody can do about it.
All right. You got a match right now.
Yes, sir.
Go in the ring right now and teach this man exactly what it feels like to be taken down by a member of Team Icon. Now, does Lance want to get back over here?
Well, Lance has taken lead. Let's introduce the match in the ring, and we'll get to the
Michael,
match right now.
We are set for more action. One fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, wrestling out of Helena, Arkansas, weighing 324 pounds, here's Buster Johnson. His opponent, wrestling out of Sweetwater, Texas, weighing...
Well, this match gets underway before
the
introduction.
What's this massive animal right here? A man I brought into Team Icon because 305 pounds, 6'7", a huge mountain of a man.
Well, I got to say,
I didn't bring him in for no reason. I brought him in because he's good. Look at him. Look how
he's a massive individual. He's a good wrestler. And I got to say, you've got some impressive looking wrestlers here. You got some gold around your weight.
Look at that. Look at that move. They almost broke the ring.
But isn't this taking this Team Icon and all a little too far? I mean, you just became the unified heavyweight champion. I mean, within a matter of hours, you're putting together a whole
Absolutely.
Syndicate?
Wait a minute. Hey, Hulk, bring him over here.
Wait a minute. What is this? Dutch Mantell, what is this?
I want him to kiss my feet right now.
Come here. Dutch Mantell up on the table here. This is Richard. Get out, Dutch. Mantell standing rain.
Make him do it again.
Kiss your butt!
Blackjack Bradshaw bringing Dr. Johnson over and humiliating him here, right here on the table. Matchmaker James Beard, where is he?
He should be kissing my feet anyway. And you should be kissing my feet. Les Russell, you should be kissing my feet. All these fans should be kissing my feet.
Justin Hawk with a side suplex, and down goes Buster Johnson as Dutch Mantell and the team icon stand
Doomsday
in presence.
Price and Justin Hawk Bradshaw, a new formation, team icon. We're going to rip some people into it.
Whoa! That.
Take him out, Hawk.
Clothesline. Holy cow. This could be it. One, two, three. No doubt about it. No doubt about it. Team icon here. They get the victory. Lance, if you could.
Dutch, will you get those thugs and get out of here?
Yeah.
Dutch. Well, I'm telling you what, that's the kind of stuff that endears you to nobody.
Poor Buster. Really getting worked over by that Justin Hawk Bradshaw.
Gets worked over, gets humiliated, and then Dutch Mantell comes out here and just tries to destroy the studio.
Let's take time out, and we'll be back right after we take a break.
Memphis Furniture Manufacturing Company now has two locations to serve you. 715 South Camilla, one block off Crump Boulevard, and their new showroom at 3270 Austin Peay in the Austin Peay Plaza, just down from the Raleigh Springs Mall. Memphis Furniture carries their own accounts, and with brands like Bassett, Benchcraft, Ashley, and Vaughn Bassett, you know you're buying quality. Time for a new mattress? Memphis Furniture is the place because they are the manufacturer. Visit Memphis Furniture at 715 South Camilla or 3270 Austin Peay. Open an account or lay away at Memphis Furniture today.
Hey, you want some pizza?
No, I don't want pizza. I'm driving.
Gee, I dropped my fries.
Hey, you're messing up my car.
Oh, drop the ketchup.
Oh, great.
Everybody needs a little KFC.
Now you can try the new Bacon Ranch Twister, plus a Pepsi, just $2.99.
Dennis Hall's Auto Salvage, home of a million parts. Call or come by 3100 Gill Road and see Dennis Hall's large inventory of both domestic and foreign parts. Bumper-to-bumper body parts used in rebuilt engines and transmissions. They also specialize in both new and used glass replacement for all makes and models of cars and trucks. For steering column and theft repair, Dennis Hall's guarantees the lowest prices in Memphis.
Hi, I'm Dennis Hall. For the best prices in town, come on down.
It's a jungle out there, so don't get ambushed by high car prices. Come to Covington Pike Chrysler.
Now buy a Jeep Grand Cherokee from just $17,995. Only $17,995, and these program Grand Cherokees are loaded. Automatic, air, power, everything, AM, FM, stereo, cassette, and more. 95 Grand Cherokees from just $17,995.
Graham, got one of Jane for me.
Covington Pike, Chrysler, living on Covington Pike.
I've got $50 bill, 50, 55, 55, and $60 bill. I have $60 bill and a 5 to go, 65, and 70 to go, 70 to 5, make it 5, 75 to go, $80 bill. I have $80 bill and a 5 to 5, 80 and a 5, 85, and 90 to go, 90, 90 and a 5. I have $90 bill and a 5 to be good, 5, 90 and a 5, 95 bill and a 100 bill. I have $100 bill and a 5 to 5, 100.
Hi, I'm Red, and this is my commercial.
This is my McDonald's.
Yeah! Where you can get a color the weather form like I did. This is me drawing. Now this is where I turned in my Color the Weather drawing. Winners drawn at random will see their art on WMC Action News AM and win cool prizes from McDonald's.
Hi, I'm Jim, and this is my McDonald's.
So if you want to be a television star like me, Color the Weather with McDonald's and TV5 today.
1 acre, 2 acres, 3 acres, four. Snapper Tractors, a complete line that's built to last. From suburban lawns to sprawling estates, Snapper has the right tractor for you. And right now, your lawn won't be the only thing cut when you buy a Snapper. During Snapper's factory-authorized end-of-season clearance, prices have been slashed, and for the biggest savings of the year, like this Snapper Tractor. Regularly $22.99, now just $19.99.99. You save $300. Call 1-800-SNAPPER for your local Snapper dealer today.
This portion of USWA Championship Wrestling is brought to you by Bill Blake Auto Insurance.
Remember, a little bit later in the show, we've got coming up the USWA TV time limit tag team championship match with the new champion Steve Dunn and Flash Flanagan defending against the former champ PG-13. That's still to go in what is already quite a show that we've had today. Let's fire it to Tony and get the out-of-town action for the USWA. Tony, my boy.
All right, thanks a lot, Lance Russell. Before I get to the on-tour action, I want to remind everyone in the Walnut, Mississippi area that Lawler's Army softball team will be in Walnut, Mississippi tomorrow at 1:30 p.m. right there at the softball field, and they will be playing the winners of the tournament in Walnut, Mississippi. That's tomorrow at 1:30. Now, let's get right into the action. Thursday night, Lula, Mississippi's Lady Luck Casino right there. Thursday night, August the 14th, you are going to see all the top stars of the USWA this Thursday night and August 14th at the Lady Luck Casino. Lance, I'm looking forward to going back to the Lady Luck. Great fans up there.
Boy, I'll tell you that. They really do and have had some great action. I've been impressed with the caliber of action there, Tony.
Oh, yeah. And then Friday night, August 15th, we're going to be at the Obion County Fair. The Obion County Fair, Friday night, August the 15th. Looking forward to that one as well. Then, Friday night, August the 22nd, we make our long-awaited return to Kennett, Missouri. That's Friday night, August the 22nd, at the American Legion Building. And fans in Kennett know about wrestling like that concession stand brawl about 5 years ago. Anything can happen, Lance, when the USWA comes to Kennett.
They told me it's been too long since we've been up there, and there it is, coming August 22nd.
I'm looking forward to Kennett, Missouri. Also looking forward to Saturday, August 23rd. We are going to be at the Cotton Festival right there in Crockett Mills, Tennessee. Saturday, August 23rd at the Cotton Festival. Then rounding out the on-tour, Friday, August 29th, Clarksdale, Mississippi. Looking forward to making our way back to Clarksdale. It's been a long time coming. Great wrestling fans all up near in the Clarksdale area. We'll be looking for that one on August 29th. Also, Lance, last night right here in Memphis, the Big One Expo Center, wild action. Looking forward to coming back.
Yeah, it was, Tony. That was a situation, Michael, where the weather was just terrible last night. I mean, you know, it could be worse, but it was just steady rain all day and that. And still a great crowd on hand and great action. We're going to be showing you some of the highlights of the action that took place out there. Unified title, the Southern Tag, or the USWA tag title. And we'll have those pictures coming up for you. But we do want to announce that the very next appearance coming in, the big one, is going to be
August 31st. Boom. That's a Sunday at the big one. USWA Wrestling returns here to Memphis at the big one on Sunday, August 31st. Circle your calendar now because a gigantic card is being signed for the reappearance of USWA at the big one on Sunday, August 31st.
You better believe we'll have all the information as we get it. Just as quick as we get it, we'll let you in on it, too. Want to say that last night, that action where Jerry the King Lawler put up his unified title against the hair on the body of Dutch Mantell, had all the makings of an outstanding match, and it was. Upset is what happened, but let's take a look. Unified heavyweight title on the line. The King, Jerry Lawler, the champion, going against the challenger, Dutch Mantell, who just got wailed with that forearm, and down on the floor he goes, and Lawler right in behind him.
A veteran match, and right here in the early going of the match, as you see, the King has having things go his way as he's got Dutch in a world of trouble right now, pounding his head against the desk at ringside. Now he's up on that second strand, coming down with that fifth. And at this point, it looked like Lawler was going to take the victory in very quick fashion.
Yes, and that's exactly the reason why we refer to it as an upset. Look at here. You know who that is. Big Doomsday, the USWA heavyweight champion, comes in. But Brian Christopher gets in behind to keep him out. Rod Price makes an interference in it, Michael.
Well, right here, Rod Price picks up this chair. He's going to nail the King with it. The King ducks, and he nails Mantell with it. And watch Lawler. He just throws that uppercut. Rod Price out of the way. He's going to hit him with that chair. And now Dutch is down. Dutch down with the effect of the chair. Lawler, with his attention diverted, getting Rod Price out of the action. Now, right now, this looks like it's it for Dutch Mantell. But in out of nowhere comes Blackjack. He nails Lawler with that cowbell. And right now, you see Dutch Mantell already groggy, covering Lawler. One, two, three, a very controversial victory.
Yes, it was a victory for Dutch Mantell. The referee was distracted. You couldn't see it on the camera that well exactly who it was, but it was Justin Hawk Bradshaw who came in there. Remember, Dutch had managed him in the WWF, and he had him right there to cover all bases, and he got in and certainly did that as he ended up banging Lawler, putting him down, getting the 1-2-3, and there is where the title change took place.
In reality, four men beat Lawler last night. Four men caused the Unified Heavyweight Championship, or rather, to change hands.
But that's not going to change the fact that we do have to put up with the current Unified World Heavyweight Champion, Dirty Dutch Mantell. Lawler had some comments to make about it after the match was over with, and we want to air them for you right now. Jerry?
Sure, you've all heard the old saying, nice guys finish last, huh? You try to do somebody a favor, and it comes back to haunt you. And that's exactly what's happened to me. Dutch Mantell, you Yosemite Sam-looking idiot, I tried to do you the biggest favor in life. I tried to shave all of that nasty, stinking, matted, filthy hair off of your face and off of your head and make you look like a human being. But no, that didn't happen, did it? Instead, I wind up without the Unified World Heavyweight Championship belt. That's right. You're the champion now, Dutch. You're the big cheese, the head honcho. You got the title around your waist, and I'm sure you've called every radio station, every TV station, every newspaper, everybody. Oh, no, I know you're on that computer. Yeah, you're emailing it out everywhere. Dutch Mantell's the new champ, right? Well, you better enjoy it while you can, Dutch, because I'm going to tell you something. You know, and I know, and everybody that's seen that tape knows that you didn't do it alone. You had a lot of help, didn't you, Dutch? And you know why you didn't do it alone? It's simple. Because you can't. You knew that by yourself, one-on-one with me, Dutch Mantell, you didn't have a prayer. You wouldn't have won that match. So, boy, you called in the reinforcements. Well, let me tell you something. That's fine. Enjoy it while you can, Dutch. Have your 15 minutes of fame. Because it's about to come to a screeching halt. I'm just going to tell you this. I'm going to make it short and sweet. The old saying is, don't get mad, get even. So I'm not going to scream and shout. I'm not going to yell and holler. I'm just going to tell you the simple facts. Next time we face each other, Dutch Mantell, I ain't coming alone. I'm going to have a nice, big, fat surprise for you, pal. So get ready. Because you can wear that belt for a little while, but don't get too used to it. Because just as soon as I get back in the ring with you, it's gone like that.
Yeah, better pay attention to what he's saying right there. Standing with me, John Miller. John, we are delighted to have you here with us today. John is here on a special mission, and I think it's one of those things that we sometimes stop and think, and I hope that we do at least. Maybe we ought to be doing a little something. John, tell them about it.
Thank you, Lance. I belong to an organization called Variety Children's Charities, and this organization raises thousands of dollars for the Mid-South area for handicapped and underprivileged children. Throughout the year, we have various fundraisers, such as a giant tent sale, which we just completed. We're going to have a bowl-a-thon in November. And what I'm here to do is to pledge other people to join this great organization to help the children in the Mid-South area.
You know, John, it's one of those things that you stop and wonder sometimes about our appearance here on this earth. And son of a gun, one of the things you ought to be able to do is help somebody else out, and nobody deserves it more than the kids in there. Here's an opportunity to do it, to join a group of people who are doing exactly that. Not going to bend your ear all day. Let me see. I've got a number right here. This is a phone number. where you can be contacted in terms of joining to where they can get together and find the joys of helping in this organization. It is 323-2220. That's the phone number to call. If you can find it in your heart to give it a little of your time, call some guys that have a lot of fun and really go to sleep and feeling real good at nighttime. Join John Miller with the activities. John, thanks a lot. Thank you for your help in the organization. That's the biggest thing.
Thank you, Lance. I appreciate it.
Thanks a lot, buddy. Let's go to the ring. We've got action, Michael, and we'll go to Tony.
Thanks a lot, Lance. We are ready to go with more action today. One fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing already in the ring, wrestling out of Phoenix, Arizona, weighing 215 pounds, here is Lance Jade. His opponent, soon to be making his way to the ring area, wrestling out of Tulsa, Oklahoma, weighing 280 pounds, Bulldog Reigns.
Hold on a second here. Bulldog Reigns, you're supposed to be in the ring.
Well, I got a little something to say. Listen here, for the last few weeks here, I haven't been too great, but I took last week off, and I'm promising these people, I don't care about these people or anybody else, I'm promising myself, you, and everybody else in the USWA, I'll get a win here today, or something drastic's going to happen. I promise you that. They'll not call me a loser ever again around here. I promise you that.
All right, Bulldog Reigns says he's going to get a win today. Let's go to the ring and find out if he can back up his words, Lance.
Seemed to me the last time that I saw him, Michael, he said exactly the same thing. I'm going to get my win today. Hey, I'm all for the guy. I mean, you know, he's making such a big deal out of the thing. Lance Jade has other ideas. This is a newcomer that came up, about 4 weeks ago, and he got a 1 3/4 count. Takes him down, small package. Almost had him right there.
Bulldog Reigns right now, reverting back to a little choke there, puts him into the ropes. Lance, and look at this. Irons. Oh, up and over he goes. One, two, count of two. Well, Bulldog Reigns almost had his three counts on Lance Jade right there. And I got to tell you, Bulldog Reigns looks like he is very intent on staying after his man. He's not giving him much breathing room. Follow him around. Look at this, right here on the floor. Picks him up. Oh.
Snaps his leg right over on that studio floor. Throws Lance Jade back in the ring again. Jade hit his head on those steps as he was thrown out of the ring by Bulldog Reigns. He is more intense today, I think, than I've seen him any time, Michael.
Well, you mentioned earlier he came out a couple of weeks ago and said he was going to get a victory here on television and fell a little short. But look at that! Lance Jade with that drop kick out of the corner stuns Bulldog Reigns. Reigns into the ropes. Hip toss, Lance Jade setting it up. Now reverses inside headlock, but now Bulldog Reigns taking over. Belly to back, suplex, over he goes. And Bulldog Reigns right back with the intensity on Lance Jade.
Man, he has got all the tools. One, two, three.
He got it.
He got it.
He got his victory.
Yes.
Well, he's going to be one happy fella.
You got it.
Oh. That was a long time coming.
Unbridled happiness by Bulldog Reigns as he beat a good young man in Lance Jade in there. He was just so intent, there was no losing that one. Still got that USWA Tag Championship match coming up later in the program. Be back in just a moment.
Dollar to the max at Maxi Foods. Enjoy deep discounted specials like these. Hyde Park Bleach, 69 cents. Miss Goldie Whole Fryers, 47 cents a pound. Yellow onions, 99 cents a bag. Extra detergent, $1.99 for the family box. And so dry paper towels, 3 for $1. Enjoy maximum savings and customer satisfaction at Maxi Foods. Now at two locations, Winchester at Mill Branch and Third at Rains. Take your food dollar to the max at Maxi Foods.
Dear Dave, we were coming home from the track the other day and saw Wendy's Smoky Bacon Cheeseburger was back, so I bought a bunch of them for the boys. Man, was it delicious. Three strips of hickory smoked bacon, smoked cheddar, savory sauce, and sautéed onions. And they made them fresh when I ordered them, so they were hot and juicy. Stop by sometime and I'll show you the new car. Your buddy, Dale Jarrett.
Dear Dale, that'd be great. I'd love to take it for a spin.
He's kidding, right?
I've been
to Wendy's and try our smoky bacon cheeseburger today.
Hi, I'm Suzanne DePriest, general manager of All-Star Chevrolet Geo Polaris in Olive Branch, Mississippi. If you're in the market for a newer used car or truck, look no further. At All-Star, we have the Mid-South's best selection of tough Chevy trucks. And if I don't have the color or option you're looking for, I'll get it from my brother Drew, general manager of All-Star Motors of Greenville. Cars or trucks, new or used, I've got it. We're located at Highway 78 and Craft Road in Olive Branch, just 5 minutes from Memphis. I promise you'll like the way my family does business.
Get it on at Greg's Store for Men. Greg's is all that and a lot more. It's the best place in Memphis to get your fashion on with the biggest brand names in the business. Get hooked up for school, a show, a special occasion, or for just chilling. Greg's is down with a large selection of shirts, shorts, jeans, caps, and all the latest athletic shoes and hikers. So don't take long. Go on and get it on at all Greg's locations.
All right, back with you on Championship Wrestling. And I tell you, Lance, we said earlier in the program that this was a week of upsets in the USWA, and one of the biggest, of course, was the fact that the USWA Tag Team Championship changed hands. PG-13 loses the belt to the team of Steve Dunn and Flash Flanagan. And boy, that's quite an upset in the wrestling world and here in the USWA.
Yeah, it is. You know, the guys take it as an exception. What do you say it's an upset in there? Well, the reason is, PG-13 has been a long-time holder of those belts. These guys, while young, they have plenty of experience. They have plenty of experience defending that title. And believe me, they know how to do it. But Dunn and Flanagan were up to the cat. Let's take a look at some of the action that took place in that title match.
One of the big reasons that this is probably termed as an upset, or is termed as an upset, is the fact that Dunn and Flanagan really haven't been together that long.
That's exactly right.
And Flash Flanagan, where he is a very good wrestler, is a very young wrestler who is really just learning the ropes of tag team competition. And to take this victory the way they did in an impressive fashion over PG-13 was very, very strong for Diamond, or for Dunn, rather, and for Flash Flanagan.
Looked like that was an opportunity missed by Flash Flanagan when the referee was being distracted in there. As it turned out, they obviously came back with the victory because they have the belts today and will be defending them here on television against PG-13 in a match ordered by matchmaker James Beard. Right now, Wolfie whips him across the make that J.C. Ice whips him across the rope. Into the corner, and Flanagan down in the middle of it. That's Wolfie leaning on the ropes in the back left. Kind of 1-2. And almost got that third count, Michael.
Right now, looks like everything going the way of J.C. Ice. He and Wolfie D making the worst of a best situation, or the best of a worst situation, if you would. But now, as you can see, the tide beginning to turn. Action outside the ring, and then action in the ring. There's a roll-up. And in the ring right now is 187, PG-187, and then he nailed, I believe that was Dunn with that hubcap, and now all of a sudden it just all heck breaks loose here. And now coming to the ring, you see Rex King distracting the referee, and from behind, here comes Paul Diamond. He's got a hubcap, and it looked like he was going to nail Steve Dunn with it, and now Dunn and Diamond are struggling over that hubcap. J.C. Ice gets in the way. Diamond drop kicks Dunn, and pins J.C. Ice, and they get the victory.
1-2-3, and in addition to that, they get the belts. And so it was a situation where Paul Diamond came in there to get done. Let's go with Michael and see what
Paul Diamond
and
Rex King out here right now.
Did I hear you guys right? Did you say Stephen Dunn and Flash Flanagan are defending against PG-13? How in the hell is that possible?
That's what the matchmaker James Beard has ordered, a rematch because of the controversial finish
I
of the match.
I don't know what is going on here. PG-13 lost last night. They blew their chance. It should be Rex and I. We've defeated Stephen Dunn and Flash Flanagan before. And I know who's behind all this. It's you, you lowlife, Stephen Dunn. You know we can beat you. You left Rex King behind. You left me behind. All you're worried about is yourself. Now you wonder why is it everything's coming back on you. Well, let me tell you something. If not today, it's going to happen.
Here comes PG-13, and they're the former Belton.
It's all your fault. What are we talking about? I'll tell you what we're talking about. You're nothing but a midget, and you lost. You fumbled the ball last night. You fumbled the ball last night. You guys don't know what Parker was there like that. Come here, Parker, way of sucking nose in our business. We would still be champions anyway. You did. And you know what? Now I know.
Here comes matchmaker James Beard and the referee. Let's get this. Let's get them settled. Let's get them sorted here. PG-13 obviously upset by the comments of Paul Diamond, Rex King, that came out here. The match has been set. Let's get with matchmaker James Beard. The match is set, right?
The match is set. We're going to have a title match for Fizz tonight, a rematch from last night. That's the way it's going to be. I don't care what you say. Russo, I'm the one that made the match, and that's the way it's going to be. You understand me? You get your chance when the time comes.
And they are the former title holders, so they get a shot at the return.
Today.
And that will be today on the program. So, Lance, I'll tell you, Paul Diamond and Rex King obviously upset about the situation, but the former title holders have the shot of getting the belt back.
Well, and I got to tell you, Michael, while we have not had the opportunity, because the forming of it just happened, with Paul Diamond and Rex King, I'm waiting to see these guys in action. We get a good chance today. Look at this match. Tony will tell you what it is.
All right, thanks a lot, Lance. We are ready to go with more action. A tag team match scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first at a combined weight of 472 pounds, here's the team of Rex King and Paul Diamond. Their opponents at a combined weight of 561 pounds, the team of the Spellbinder and the Free Spirit, Rick Titan.
How about that?
One fall, 10 minutes in time.
I love this match that James Beard has lined up for us on television.
Boy.
Spellbinder and Rick Titan, who you know him probably as Razor Ramon better, but he jumped Razor Ramon into the trash can, and he's out. Rick Titan with Spellbinder going against Rex King and Paul Diamond. And as I said, Michael, I've been anxious to see Diamond and King together against some good competition.
I'll tell you, this is one heck of a matchup. Kudos to matchmaker James Beard putting this match on television to begin with, because this is four outstanding athletes in there. But we're going to get a first-hand look at how Diamond and King work together. But we're also going to get a good look on how Spellbinder and Rick Titan work together. So this should be very interesting.
Yeah. Large lads that are in there for this match today. And Titan came in. King caught him with a foot, misses with that sweeping arm, and here comes all of PG-13 out. Standing by as Wolfie, J.C. Ice, and 187. Look at Titan. Took King up and hammered him down. King kind of had things going his way. If we mentioned again, for those who are not familiar with it, that Stephen Dunn and Rex King were former partners.
They were former tag team partners, and then they had an altercation. Steve Dunn went his own way. Rex King went his own way. And now Rex King returns to the USWA as the partner of another former Steve Dunn partner, Paul Diamond. And right now, when I look here and I see PG-13 standing outside the ring watching the action of Diamond and Rex King, it looks like they're as intent on finding out what kind of team Diamond and King are as much as we and the fans are.
They were hacked off at King and Diamond for what they consider to be going in a place where they don't belong. PG-13 says, hey, we were the champions. What are you doing out here trying to make noise like you ought to be in there? Woo, Diamond slips the foot right on Spellbinder. A reversal, Diamond into the rope. Power in the air. Boom.
Spellbinder
right off his feet.
Nailed him with that inverted atomic drop, caught him with the clothesline coming off. But Paul Diamond, the veteran that he is, kicking off at the toque out. I got to tell you, Lance, when you see these guys in action, and I'm talking about PG-13, I'm talking about Diamond and King, I'm talking about Dunn and Flash Flanagan, you've got three of the top tag teams in the country right here in the USWA right now, and they all three are in each other's throat.
No, I mean, they are not only in their face, they're in their throats, Michael says. And Spellbinder wheels the arm around and takes him right into the turnbuckle, hit his mouth right on that turnbuckle. Good night, and look at King and Diamond putting the boots to him as referee Downtown Bruto trying to get him separated. And Spellbinder pounded on, back into the rope, the whip coming off the rope, the elbow puts him on the floor.
Rex King, I think, too, has added a dimension to Paul Diamond, and then he sort of brought out the viciousness of Paul Diamond. Paul has always been a rough, tough wrestler, but this Rex King, I mean, this is one really vicious son of a gun, as you can see right now.
Look at this guy move, for and let me tell you, he's no outside junior heavyweight. This is a big guy. He's in there with some big guy. Whoa, double elbow, and down goes the Spellbinder. Is Diamond and King looking very strong today?
Absolutely, and I'm sure they're trying to prove to matchmaker James Beard and the USWA that they deserve that title shot. But right now, the team in line for that is the team of PG-13, of JC Ice, Wolfie D, and PG-187.
That last move by Spellbinder was pure strength. There's the tag on the Razor. Nope, make that Rick Titan. We just can't know what we're saying. Rex King slam, all Diamond down on the mat. Diamond and King have much more tag experience than do Spellbinder and Rick Titan. And I think it's showing right now, Michael, was.
Absolutely, Lance. But I'll say one thing. We may be seeing the formation of still another tag team in the USWA in Titan and Spellbinder. They are looking very good. Look at this. Rick Titan catches him off the ropes. He's got him covered. Paul Diamond in to drop the elbow and break it up before the count can commence.
Spellbinder and Diamond going at each other. Rick Titan and Rex King at each other as Titan trying to say, look like he was going into the room. He was just getting ready to pick him up and go for a power bomb, I believe. Look at King, rolls him up, bridges one, two, three, got him. What a match that son of a gun was. And a big victory. PG-13, hey, come on, Bruno.
Well, they were waiting. They were guarding the dressing room door as they watched this match. And the three members of PG-13 with a greeting of Paul Diamond and Rex King. And they're trying to get at him. And the referees are out. Matchmaker James Beard is out to keep them separated. And, boy, this is a very volatile situation.
PG-13 did not interfere during the match. But when King and Diamond came out victorious, they really jumped at each other. And PG-13 Wolfie D is telling Rex King, you're the next one. What a battle. We'll take time out. Let's go. Go ahead.
Don't touch that remote, fans. Coming up next, the Madman Rod Price. Stay with us.
Now you can buy a nice car, too. Credit problems? No problem. Come to Schaefer Motors at 3360 Elvis Presley Boulevard. If you have slow, weak, bad credit, no credit, bankrupt, we can help. We have late model cars at prices you can't afford. Zero down with the trade-in. If you've ever been denied credit at any other area dealers, we can help. Down payment as low as $7.99 and approval in 1 hour. Come by 3360 Elvis Presley between Winchester and Brooks Road for a fine pre-owned car.
You know, I've been in Memphis a long time. Bill Blake Insurance has, too. If you have never checked out the hometown boys at Bill Blake Insurance, then you're missing a Memphis tradition. Respect, service, and good value is part of doing business at Bill Blake Insurance.
I've been doing business with Bill Blake Insurance for years. He's always there when you need him, and you only have to make one payment per month.
I sing the blues all over the world, but I always come home and I always see the hometown boys at Bill Blake Insurance. At Bill Blake Insurance, he's from Memphis.
Get it on at Greg's Store for Men. Greg's is all that and a lot more. It's the best place in Memphis to get your fashion on with the biggest brand names in the business. Get hooked up for school, a show, a special occasion, or for just chilling. Greg's is down with a large selection of shirts, shorts, jeans, caps, and all the latest athletic shoes and hikers. So don't take long. Go on and get it on at all Greg's locations.
An uninsured motorist hit my work vehicle, totaled it, injured me, so I needed some legal advice. A friend told me about Gaddy Keltner Bienvenue Montesi, so I made the call.
If you're injured in an accident, Gaddy Keltner Bienvenue and Montesi's more than 125 years of experience can get you the money you deserve.
I was sure Gator Keltner, BMW, and Montesi could take care of my needs, and they did just that. Gator Keltner, BMW, and Montesi helped me out of a hard spot, and I'm real glad I called.
Tony Friedman back here on USWA Championship Wrestling, along with all these great fans. We are set to go with more action today, scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, already in the ring, weighing 223 pounds, wrestling out of Long Beach, California, please welcome Bobby Bronz. His opponent, soon to be making his way to the ring area, wrestling out of Los Angeles, California, weighing 289 pounds, here's the California stud, Rod Price. One fall, 10-minute time limit.
Well, Dutch Mantell's out here again, Lance, with his team icon, if you would.
Yeah.
Referee calling for the bell, and we're ready for action. It's Rod Price, and talk about viciousness. This is one vicious son of a gun in there against Bobby Bronz. And Dutch Mantell in his tuxedo carrying a unified belt, raising the ire of the fans across the ring. And in the meantime, Rod Price just takes immediate control inside the ring.
I bet he hadn't let that out of his hands.
You see what I'm doing, Lance? It surprises me you don't get up and leave the desk right now. Team Icon is taking over the USWA.
This young man that's in there with Rod Price is a guy who's really eager. He is giving away an awful lot of size. And if anybody ever deserved the handle that they tagged on him, Madman Rod Price, it is Price, because one, two, three, that's all.
He made short work of Bobby Bronz right there.
You ever get my name wrong again? I'm gonna knock you down.
Some of these guys out here.
Dutch is going to manage it. I don't know if Dutch can control himself, much less that group.
Jeez.
You okay?
Yeah, all right. Anyhow, Price ends up with a quick victory, and this guy's tough. There's no doubt. He's another one that's got all the physical attributes, all of that. He is so wild and so totally uncontrollable, and he ends up showing it in there. I'm sorry, for the young man, Bronz, but he just was in there with a tough guy. We've got more of it. Hey, Tag Team Championship coming up before the day is over.
It's almost quitting time in the hard cash zone at Circus Casino. And while construction may be nearly complete, the action is still going strong as we give away $500,000 in cold hard cash. For your chance to win, just visit the hard cash zone at Circus Casino now through the end of August. We're giving away $2,500, $5,000, even $10,000 at a time. So before you get your first look at a new brand of excitement, get another look at the hard cash zone in Circus Casino.
Dear Dave, when I saw Wendy's Smoky Bacon Cheeseburger was back, I said, that sounds good to me. So I got them for the whole firehouse. Some guys especially like the three strips of hickory smoked bacon, some the two slices of smoked cheddar and savory sauce, and we all agreed that we never had a hotter, juicier, more delicious bacon cheeseburger. Dave, come on by. We'll let you wear a big hat and ring the bell.
Dear Jerry, can I drive the truck?
Come into Wendy's and try our Smoky Bacon Cheeseburger today.
Hey, Clarence, what are you doing?
Just doing my job. Everything is priced to move.
Clarence has been pretty busy during your Ford dealer's factory-authorized clearance. He's offering low 4.8% financing or $1,500 cash back on a new Doors. Or get 4.8 financing on Explore.
Wow! Now that's big savings.
Remember, Ford has more vehicles with a 5-star safety rating than any other manufacturer. So hurry to your local Ford dealer's factory-authorized clearance.
That's Clarence.
At the Happy Hawker, you'll find all kinds of merchandise at incredible savings. If you like to pay reasonable prices when you buy jewelry, diamonds, musical instruments, cameras, TVs, VCRs, tools, and guns. If you're the kind of person who really searches for just the right gift at just the right price, then you may make a great pawn shopper. Need cash? See us for the lowest rates on loans with the area's only drive-in loan department. Visit either Happy Hawker location, 975 East Parkway South, or our new superstore at 299 North Cleveland.
spirituality is more important than ever. That's why Action News 5 is the first television station to focus on faith with our weekly series, People of Faith. And our commitment doesn't stop there. Ben Watson's Family Focus each Wednesday, Family Healthcast, Hometown Heroes, and more. Family and faith. Because we're all searching for purpose and truth.
Sitting up here is easy to ignore what's going on down there underneath your car.
That is until your steering begins to shimmy.
Or your suspension starts to go. So before you lose control, go to Meineke, the undercar experts.
Shocks, struts, CV joints. Dependable, high-quality parts and fast professional service. All at that great Meineke price.
So avoid headaches. If it's under your car, Meineke has it under control.
At Meineke, you're not going to pay a lot, but you'll get a lot.
I guarantee it.
Harold Grader hosts Sports Sunday, Sunday at 10:30 on Action News 5.
Boy, we have another super crowd here today. Yeah, they are. They're great and have really enjoyed the action that takes place, and they came free. And you saw the ticket location where you can write your tickets to get your tickets to USWA Wrestling. But, Michael, we got a couple of locations that people now, for the first time, can go by and pick up tickets, right?
Absolutely, Lance, and they are free. All you have to do is drop by Above the Rim Sports Cards. That's at 4500 Summer Avenue, or at Applebee's, the location at 6482 Poplar. So either one of those locations, just drop by, say you want some tickets to come to see the action here on Saturday of Championship Wrestling, and you'll enjoy it just like these fans do each and every Saturday.
Oh, you better believe it. Looking forward to being up here. Another thing we're looking forward to is having you folks out of town. When it comes your way, you be sure and be there. Here's the man that's got the location, Tony.
Thanks, Lance. We have a lot of action coming up on the USWA Tour. Let's take a look at it. Like this Thursday night, the Lady Luck Casino right there in Lula, Mississippi. Thursday night, August the 14th, we return to the Lady Luck Casino. Hopefully, we will have a lot of great fans come out. Thursday night, August the 14th, Lady Luck Casino. We'll see you there. Then from there, we're going to be Obion County Fair. The Obion County Fair, Friday night, August the 15th, right there at the Obion County Fair. Looking forward to that one. Then the long-awaited return of USWA Wrestling to Kenan, Missouri, and the American Legion Building. That all takes place Friday night, August the 22nd, right there in Kenan, Missouri. Then from there, Saturday, August 23rd, Crockett Mills, Tennessee, at the Cotton Festival. And Friday, August 29th, Clarksdale, Mississippi. That's the USWA on tour. Also, Memphis wrestling fans, you have something to get excited about. Wrestling action coming back to the big one. And here to tell you all about it, Mr. Lance Russell.
Yes, sir. Coming back August the 31st. And that is a Sunday, right?
That is a Sunday. Uh-huh. Big action.
Big one. Please put that down so that you can be out there with us and watch the action. We'll tell you as soon as the card is ready for release and we can talk about the individual matches. Here comes some brand new champions, Stephen Dunn. Feeling pretty happy, and I don't blame him. I want to say, Blaze, congratulations on a win that was hampered by folks jumping in and all of this kind of stuff, but you guys persevered.
I tell you what, we are fired up. First and foremost, I want to thank all the great USWA fans, because without you, we couldn't have done it, baby. I'll tell you what, PG-13 put up one heck of a fight. Let's get down to business right now. There's two other guys on my mind right this minute that's been out here running their mouth about me. That's Paul Diamond and Rex King. Now, let me tell you boys something. You call this guy boy? Well, let me tell you something. This boy is wearing the USWA World Tag Team title.
Better believe he is.
Now, let me tell you something, Paul Diamond. You showed your true colors, and believe me, I know Rex King's true colors. It's just a matter of time before you two have end up butting heads. But that's none of my business. What is my business is we got a match against PG-13 today on TV. Yeah! We're going to hold on to these belts. And when we're done with PG-13, anytime, anywhere, it don't make any difference to us. You just bring it on. We'll sign the dotted line. We're not backing down from nobody.
Flash, this is what you dreamed about, having that belt around your waist, but you're in the middle of the heat, brother. You got to be ready to stand.
Well, Lance, I just don't even care anymore. You just bring him on, and me and Steve will take him out.
Okay.
We got Sam right here. He don't care.
All right. Steven Dunn. Going with Flash Flanagan, Michael.
I'll tell you, they formed one heck of a tag team, and they took those tag team belts in record time here in the USWA. And speaking of record time in the USWA and here at the big one, we had some action for the USWA heavyweight title match last night at the big one that we want to take a look at.
And very exceptional match, too, for the USWA.
It was, and for the first time ever, a triangular match, which means there are three men involved. And here we pick up the action. You see the awesome Doomsday, who is the champion, in up against Brian Christopher. And as you see, Spellbinder waiting outside the ropes for his shot. Brian Christopher up with that flying drop kick off the second rope. Brian Christopher had things going. And now, as it ends up, after the tag out, Spellbinder and Brian Christopher are in the ring. And Spellbinder sets Christopher high over his head and just drops him.
In this match, Michael, a triangular match, you really have to win two matches.
To become the champion, you really do have to win two matches. And as you see there, there's some double teaming with the Spellbinder and Doomsday. And it looked as if here that the champion Doomsday would be eliminated right here. But Doomsday showing his strength right here with a DDT. And that sort of turned the tide. But then Spellbinder and Brian joined forces in reality. And they put Doomsday out of the ring. And watch this right here. This is very interesting. Spellbinder going to take a look. And while he was taking a look at Doomsday, he's rolled up by Brian Christopher and pinned. So now it's Brian Christopher against Doomsday for the title.
Right. I'm sure Spellbinder didn't appreciate that, but Brian was in there taking care of business, and he rolled him up, got one win. Now he's got to go against the very awesome Doomsday. And look at him. He's got Doomsday's mask, put it on, and now he's headbutting with it on there. And Doomsday being put down on the mat by Brian Christopher with that mask. Nailed him again with a flying headbutt.
Well, it looks as if now Brian Christopher, with things going his way, here comes the super kick.
Uh-oh.
And Brian Christopher is tripped up from outside. As you saw, Spellbinder was cheering him on, and then all of a sudden, he trips him up. Doomsday gets the victory, and Doomsday retained the USWA heavyweight title as a result.
Well, I guess he figured that what's good for the goose is good for the gander, and Spellbinder hooked that leg out there and took him right down to the mat. He had some comments to make after it was over. Let's see what the Spellbinder had to say about it.
Okay. I'm understanding the game much better now, Brian. So you want the USWA heavyweight champion? Well, you know what? So do I. And let's not forget Dangerous Doug Gilbert. He wants the belt too. But you know what? There's someone standing in front of all three of our way. And that's that 6'9", 325-pound animal they call Doomsday. And he's the one holding the belt now. So this is a race between three friends towards one goal. But you know what? I'm running the fastest. And as far as I'm concerned, there's no friends when we get into the ring, because when I get into that ring for that belt, I'm going full-fledged ahead. So you know what? Dangerous Doug Gilbert, Brian Christopher, just worry about yourself, because as far as I'm concerned, I'm taking that belt.
We have more action on the way today on Championship Wrestling. One fall with a 10-minute time limit. We're awaiting the arrival of some of our participants in this contest. Lance, big match coming up. Introducing first, making his way to the ring area, wrestling out of Lexington, Kentucky, Mike Sample. This opponent, soon to be making his way to the ring area, wrestling out of South Africa, weighing 291 pounds, returning to the USWA today, here is Recon. One fall, 10-minute time limit.
Okay, one of the big members of the Truth Commission back with us, Michael, as he is going against the movie star, Mike Sample. Referee is downtown Bruno. Bell time, and here we go.
I got to tell you, Lance, I was a bit surprised when I saw Recon on the card today, because I know he's been wrestling with the WWF as part of the Truth Commission, and quite frankly, I'm a little surprised that he's back in the USWA, but maybe he's here to settle the score. As you well know, and the fans know, Mike Samples and the Commandant had some problems here a while back, and now one-on-one, Recon against Mike Samples. Maybe Recon's back to sort of make a point or to settle the score.
That'll be it. I can't imagine that Recon would be here for any other reason. He is one of these guys that is a rough and tumble style wrestler, and he is plenty big. You look at him beside Mike Samples, And you think, well, they're not exceptionally big. Hey, Mike's a big guy, too.
Absolutely. Samples on a wily ring veteran and has some good size on him also. And Recon in here. Nice fireman carry by Samples. Drops the elbow. Samples can wrestle, and Recon, of course, can wrestle. So this should be a good one-on-one competition. And neither one really know what the rule book's all about either.
Short arm scissors. Mike Samples holding it to drag a little energy down. They bring that energy level of Recon down, but he may have to do a little bit more than that, because this guy is, while he is not the quickest gazelle type wrestler that I ever saw, brother, he knows his stuff and strong as an ox, man. He can really go with it. Recon of the Truth Commission. A reminder that we've been saying it, we're saving the best for last, as they say. We've got the USWA Tag Team Championship match that will put the new champion, Stephen Dunn and Flash Flanagan, in there defending against the former champion, PG-13. And Recon takes a couple of shots right at that knee as Mike Sample, who is not totally happy to be looking over there at the green T-shirted Truth Commission uniform, ties it up, collar and elbow, and back over to the ropes.
I'll tell you, Lance, one thing I'm beginning to notice about the USWA, you can put friendships aside. You've got the caliber of wrestlers right now in the USWA that any one of them could be a champion at any time. And I think that's very indicative of the promoters, and I think it's very indicative of the new matchmaker, James Beard, who's not afraid to put just top-notch one-on-one competition in the ring. He'll put a tag title match in the ring on television. I mean, when you go out to see the USWA, you can be assured you're going to get the very best and top-notch competition. And it's everybody for himself right now around here.
You know, I love the heavyweight division in there with Doomsday on top. This guy, it looks to me like that the smartest thing would have been for Spellbinder and Brian Christopher to stay together to beat this guy, because I don't know who else in the world is going to beat him. He is big and really tough. But you've got Christopher, you've got Spellbinder. Here, guys, he used to go to the gym and work out together. They're still friends in a sense, but they are taking care of business. They, as Spellbinder, we heard him say one time talking about, hey, I'm going to look out for myself. You guys take care of yours. Whoa, Recon went after Mike Sample, went leaping at him, and his leg got hooked up over the rope. Sample follows him right to the ring apron as Recon comes up with a chokehold, slams Sample right at the throat, knocks him down. And back into the ring he goes.
Mike Samples with his leg locked up in the ropes. Recon kicking away at Samples, pushes the referee, Downtown Bruno, out of the way. Bruno calling for the bell.
Did he say ring the bell?
Yes, he did. Yeah. He called for the bell as Mike Samples is hooked in the ropes, and Recon just going right after him. Now here comes Stevie Dunn and Flash Flanagan to get Recon out of the way, as Samples in a very precarious position, and he may have been hurt there with those continuing barrages of Recon, and that knee may have taken some damage there, as Mike Samples will get the victory on disqualification.
Mike Samples by disqualification, and he may have more to pay for it than that. He stretched that knee way out. We'll take time out. The championship match is on its way.
Let's say you have $200 and you're out to buy a new suit. You could go to a department store and buy this suit for around $200, if you're lucky. Or you could go to S&K Menswear and get two handsome wool blend suits for less than you might pay for one. This suit and this suit for less than $200. That's about half what you'd expect to pay, right? Now, where are you going to buy your next suit?
Shop the grand opening of our new superstore at the Commons, across from Wolf Chase Galleria.
Take on TV's best entertainment network, HBO, and TV's best movie network, Cinemax. Take two, HBO and Cinemax, and get six channels for the price of two with multi-channel HBO and Cinemax. That's right, when you order HBO and Cinemax, you'll get six different programs to choose from whenever you want to watch. Take two and get six. Multi-channel HBO and Cinemax. Call now.
Get 50% off installation when you buy the Smart Choice package. Call 365-6004.
You know, I've been in Memphis a long time. Bill Black Insurance has, too.
If you have never checked out the hometown boys at Bill Blake Insurance, then you're missing a Memphis tradition. Respect, service, and good value is part of doing business at Bill Blake Insurance.
Buying car insurance can be confusing, but not at Bill Blake Insurance. They can answer all your questions, and you only make one payment per month.
I sing the blues all over the world, but I always come home, and I always see the hometown boys at Bill Blake Insurance. At Bill Blake Insurance, he's from Memphis.
Another stalled car on the expressway. Traffic is backed up considerably.
Could you use a little paradise about now? Alabama's Robert Trent Jones Golf Trail, one of the top 10 trips in the world by Frequent Flyer magazine. Paula DePerna in the New York Times calls this some of the best public golf on earth. 18 championship courses, just you, not a worry in the world. Call 800-949-4444. It's not heaven, but it's close.
Main event time today on Championship Wrestling, one fall or television time remaining. This is for the USWA Tag Team titles. Introducing first, soon to be making their way to the ring area, they are the challengers today, JC Ice and Wolfie D, PG-13. Their opponents, soon to be making their way to the ring area, the reigning USWA Tag Team Champions, the team of Stephen Dunn and Flash Flanagan. One fall, expiration of time.
Okay, thank you, Tony Friedman, as he hops down, clears the deck, and I'd get away because these guys, no love at all. You see Wolfie right out there trying to egg Flash Flanagan into getting into action before he ever gets the belt from around his waist. Wolfie D, J.C. Ice, and the newest member of PG-13, originally came in here to the USWA as P.J. Walker, and then PG-13 kind of adopted him, so he was P.G. Walker, and then they started calling him 187, which is some kind of police call or something,
homicide,
I think.
Yeah,
is that what it is?
Yeah. Well, this is going to be a very interesting match because the belts are on the line, and despite the fact J.C. Ice, now he's bringing them over to the desk.
Y'all take care of our new belts. We're fixing to get back. As a matter of fact, you say, John, polish them up so we can take them to ECW.
Yeah, right.
And there's J.C. Ice running his mouth. And right away, Steve Dunn with the head scissors on Wolfie D and an arm drag takedown, and Wolfie D goes down. I'll tell you, Lance, one thing I don't like seeing is the fact that PG-187's at ringside. I mean, he's not a manager, even though he's part of the team, and this is a tag team match, and it's not a six-man tag match. It's four men, and that just always balances the scales the wrong way in my mind.
Yeah, the present 187 out there cannot be a comforting sight for Dunn or Flash Flanagan. Although Flash seems to be oblivious to the whole thing. Steven has been there before, and he kind of is aware of everything. Whoa, was he aware of that one, huh? I mean, right around behind Wolfie D. In the belly to back, takes him over and down. We got to be taking another break here as we got a little behind. But believe me, we will have the camera going. And if something happens, we will, in fact, let you be able to see it. We are in the middle of a USWA Tag Team Championship match as J.C. Ice running his mouth on the side of the ring. Stephen Dunn fired Wolfie D right into J.C., who hit the floor, and now it's down on the floor for Wolfie D. We got to take a break, Michael. We'll be back. Don't go away. We'll have it all for you, I promise. Hey!
In the year 2019, scientists say we'll travel to Mars. How you prepare is up to you. At U.S. Space Camp, you'll spend a week at the speed of light. Training, dressing, and thinking just like the real NASA astronauts. With 5 days of hands-on training that'll take you from the mind-blowing sensation of microgravity to blasting into space on an eye-popping multi-sensory flyby. And you'll do it all with kids like you, learning to work as a team to keep your mission together and your heads on straight. Call this number today and get your free Space Camp booklet and all the registration information you'll need. U.S. Space Camp. What a trip.
At the Happy Hawker, you'll find all kinds of merchandise at incredible savings. If you like to pay reasonable prices when you buy jewelry, diamonds, musical instruments, cameras, TVs, VCRs, tools, and guns. If you're the kind of person who really searches for just the right gift at just the right price, then you may make a great pawn shopper. Need cash? See us for the lowest rates on loans with the area's only drive-in loan department. Visit either Happy Hawker location, 975 East Parkway South, or our new superstore at 299 North Cleveland.
Get it on at Greg's Store for Men. Greg's is all that and a lot more. It's the best place in Memphis to get your fashion on with the biggest brand names in the business. Get hooked up for school, a show, a special occasion, or for just chilling. Greg's is down with a large selection of shirts, shorts, jeans, caps, and all the latest athletic shoes and hikers. So don't take long. Go on and get it on at all Greg's locations.
The floor. We're just saying JC is hot. He got bombed out here on the floor, and he's back complaining to Wolfie, complaining to everybody able to listen.
Well, you got to remember that JC Ice has been hurt. He hurt his knee a few weeks back and really was questionable for the tag team championship match a few evenings ago. And I got to tell you, from what I see right now, it looks like JC Ice is fine. But the fact of the matter is, Dunn and Flash Flanagan are taking the fight right to PG-13. They're fighting fire with fire.
You know, maybe I shouldn't say it. I'm going to say it anyhow. And that is the fact that I really kind of underestimated the team of Dunn and Flanagan. I didn't think they'd been together long enough. And Flash being the youngster, he flew off of there and nailed J.C. Ice right down here on the floor. But there's 87 out here. Now, that's what you were talking about, Michael. The guy's got no business interfering in it. He's not a manager. He shouldn't. Even a manager certainly shouldn't be interfering.
Illegal. That's only allowed in ECW. He's not allowed to fly over the top rope.
Ice can come up with some of the strangest rules about wrestling I've ever seen. But right now, Flash Flanagan is caught by Wolfie D, and Wolfie D pounds him down into the mat.
He was going to scissor that head and take Wolfie right on over. And you notice how Wolfie kept him off balance by wheeling him around and finally slammed him down into the mat. What a heck of a battle this one is going on. Wheeled across the ring. Clothesline as they double team on Flash Flanagan. One, two.
Typical PG-13 move in their typical fashion, but I think they may have underestimated Flash Flanagan, as that was just a nonchalant cover by J.C. Ice, and as a result, Flanagan kicked out.
One of the things that we need to mention is that this is a TV time, so in a way, it's an advantage to Flanagan Dunn as champion, because we do not have a 60-minute time limit. It is the remainder TV time that, and we're so glad when they finally got that, where we could be sure that we would have the match completed and not run out. It's one that now we know when this TV time is over with, that is going to be it, and they can keep the title or lose them or whatever. So we wanted to remind you of that. Look at J.C. Ice over there trying to bait.
And PG-187 throwing a right hand while they had Flanagan over here on the ropes. That also affects the strategy of the match. And I'll say one thing. Both teams came out here fired up and loaded for bear. They went right after each other from the opening bell, and it hasn't stopped yet.
He flipped him up. Caught his foot right on that rope. And Flash Flanagan taking a beating from PG-13. Hey, these guys are tough. We have never particularly liked that devil may care young attitude of double DDT. And down goes JC and Wolfie D. We're 1 minute away from our time limit being out. As when it comes, it's all over with, and that's a great break for Dunn and Flanagan, because Flanagan is hurt, even though he's pulled off.
He got the tag.
Oh, yeah.
Here comes Steve Dunn, and he's clean house.
Bell time coming up. As they are all four.
Here comes Rex King and Paul Diamond out of nowhere.
They couldn't stand it, Michael. They couldn't stand it.
They were out here belly aching earlier, and right now they're in the ring. PG-13 cannot be happy about this. Neither can they. Obviously, they're not. They're going right back after Diamond and Rex King. Flash Flanagan and Steve
Look
Dunn.
At this. Got PG-13 on Diamond and King. We got to take a break. I hate it, but we got to go. We still got a break today. Boy, look at him.
Dennis Hall's Auto Salvage, home of a million parts. Call or come by 3100 Gill Road and see Dennis Hall's large inventory of both domestic and foreign parts. Bumper-to-bumper body parts, used and rebuilt engines and transmissions. They also specialize in both new and used glass replacement for all makes and models of cars and trucks. For steering column and theft repair, Dennis Hall's guarantees the lowest prices in Memphis.
Hi, I'm Dennis Hall. For the best prices in town, come on down.
The big news at Sonic this summer? We've got all kinds of new drinks and desserts. And some new deals, too. We've got 5 everyday combo meals now. There's something for everyone. Extra long cheese conies, made-to-order burgers, chicken sandwiches, and they all come with fries and a medium Coke. Great deals on great food, and we don't charge extra for the fun.
We've been having fun all summer long.
Looking to save some cash on a new Ford car or truck?
For me!
During Ford's factory-authorized clearance, get low 2.9% financing on Escort or Ford Ranger. That could save you over $1,900 on Escort and $1,600 on Ranger.
Wow, that's huge!
2.9% financing could save you as much as $30 a month on Ranger, enough for a movie and dinner for two, and as much as $40 a month on Escort, enough for 3 CDs of your favorite music. Don't miss your Ford dealer's factory-authorized clearance.
Get it on at Greg's Store for Men. Greg's is all that and a lot more. It's the best place in Memphis to get your fashion on with the biggest brand names in the business. Get hooked up for school, a show, a special occasion, or for just chilling. Greg's is down with a large selection of shirts, shorts, jeans, caps, and all the latest athletic shoes and hikers. So don't take long. Go on and get it on at all Greg's locations.
Oh, got so excited, forgot to tell him who won the match, Michael.
Steve Dunn and Flash Flanagan retain the belts on disqualification because of outside interference. And, boy, what a match, Lance.
Hey, they've got a camera on in the back, and we got some hassling going on behind back there. It looks like that Paul Diamond and Rex King and PG-13. Look at Wolfie D right in Paul's face. Let me tell you, that's not a good place to get in unless you're ready to fight, boy, because these guys will go at each other in a heartbeat. I love it. Things are so exciting going down.
My credit, my hat's off to matchmaker James Beard. We had a great show today, a great lineup with victories by Brian Christopher. Bulldog Reigns got his first victory.
Yes, he did.
They're still at each other, Lance.
We got to get out of here, and so I want to tell you, be with us. I don't see how you can afford not to be. Michael St. John and Lance Russell want to say right now, bye-bye, everybody.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of USWA Championship Wrestling.